it's Sir Winston and Shirley, and we're outside. We've got our sunscreen on, and I've got my hat on, and Sir Winston has his hat on to protect his nose. He doesn't need much sunscreen. The fur covers most of him. And we're here having a look at our plants. So a couple of weeks ago, Sir Winston and I planted 4 baskets of nasturtiums. And I don't know if you can see, but nasturtiums are flowers that you can actually eat the flowers of. And these ones are in orange and yellow. And we also planted some seeds to be transplanted. A lot of people now have started gardening with the pandemic. We've done some at this place before. And really, to be a gardener is to learn about hope and optimism, that you're putting a seed in the ground and you're really hoping, your planning, your expectation is that that seed is going to grow into something. And the thing about being a gardener is sometimes you're a little disappointed. And we've probably learned about the pandemic, the things that we've hoped for, you know, that we can go see our grandparents, that we can see our friends, that we can have a birthday party. We've been disappointed about. It hasn't happened. But gardeners live with lots of hope. So we're out here looking at our plants, and in our hanging baskets, we have planted 4 nasturtium seeds. And I have 4 baskets, and one basket has 4 plants that grew. And you can kind of see them here. They're growing up, they're blowing in the wind. So I have 3 that came out in this basket. And I thought I had 2 in this basket, but Sir Winston tells me there's a very little one that's a seed there and 2 in this basket. And so what we're going to do today is we're going to plant more seeds, and we're going to hope that those seeds growing in there. So what we're going to do today is we're kind of going to plant the missing ones. So I know I took them out of 2 different seed packages. They're both nasturtiums. I'm going to put some seeds out in my hand so you can see them. And these seeds kind of are quite big, and they're supposed to be planted down 1/2 inch. So well, I've got 1, 2, 3. I'm going to plant one here. I'm making a little hole. I'm going to drop it in, cover it up. And this one here is the same thing. And 1, 2, 3. That one, drop it in, cover it up. I'm going to open up my other seed plant or seed thing, and I know that I need 2. Make a little hole. Make a little hole. And there was the seed that didn't do anything. So let's try that, hole in there, cover it up, and it said to water, so we're going to give them a little bit of water, because for things to grow, they need both water and sun. And there we've planted our seeds, and we're going to hope they're going to grow. And we were looking at other seeds that we've planted, you may be able to see along the side. We planted seeds in egg crates and in the ones that you get in the store, and we're hoping that the seeds would grow and we could just kind of break them apart, give them a lot of water and put them in the soil without having to disturb them. And we planted 3 different kinds of seeds, 12 eggs in the egg crate, 12 seeds, and didn't have any grow for peppers. We didn't have any grow for tomatoes. And right now we have 3 broccoli here. So some of the seeds take a longer time to germinate, so we're going to give them a bit of time, but we also move on to plant B. So I've got two tomato transplants, and I've got a couple of pepper transplants, because if the plants don't grow now, they're not going to have enough time to ripen. And you know, this makes us think about the pandemic. So that was sort of like plan B. And sometimes we've had plan B about things. You know, we haven't been able to get together for Sunday school, but some of our churches have plan B that our kids can, you know, you can see your friends from Sunday school on Zoom and see your teachers. But we live, we're God's people, we live in hope that all things turn out, and we have, hope is a form of trust, and we have trust in God. So in this time of pandemic and things happening, we can't go to school, we can't see our friends, we need to have hope and trust that things will turn out well. And we also need to have hope and trust in God that all things will work together to accomplish God's plans. And shall we have a little prayer? You could bow your head and repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for your world. Thank you for creation. Thank you for the people who look after me. Help me look after others. Amen. And we'll see you next time at Kids Corner.